So Janma Mrityu Jara Vyadhi, no? We saw that last time. Mani, you were there.
Yes.
We saw that. We
yes.
finished?
Yes.
Asakti?
Let me start from Vedanta.
Yeah.
Vedanta.
We finished what?
We have to start with Asakti.
Okay. So who will read? You decide to put up a fence. You inquire about the zoning laws. You go across the street.
special rule upon it. That ownership is purely emotional, and it is even more clearly seen in the case of flats or modern condominiums. A few years ago, a young friend told me that he had bought a few days in Mumbai, which he invited me to see. When we arrived at his house, I found myself looking at a seven-story structure. Since this young man has a relatively modest position, I was surprised. Who bought this? I asked. Not all of it, he laughed. I own a flat on the third floor. So we went on the third floor and he ushered me in saying, "This is mine. This is the flat I own." This was the first time I'd heard of such an arrangement, so I was puzzled. "Do you own the land?" I asked. "No," he said and explained that a cooperative management society owned the land. All he owned was a rather small flat, two rooms and a kitchen. So I asked, "What is it you own in this flat? Do you own the floor?" "No, my floor is the ceiling of the fellow downstairs." "Do you own the ceiling?" "No, the ceiling is the floor for the family upstairs." "How about the walls?" "Well, the inner walls are shared with other flats. The outer wall, of course, belongs to the whole building as part of the structural support." "So what do you own?" "Well, Samiji, I own the space." You see the nature of ownership. A claim of ownership is always connected with something over which, at the most, I can assert is a temporary possession or control. Even my right to sell that which I own is a possessing right, nothing more. I can transfer my possession or control of something to another, for which I receive certain money. This is only transfer of possession. For me to know, sorry, claim of ownership, that is actually more than a temporary possession. I would have to be the sole, absolute author of the owned object. Otherwise, many before me, as well as those who come after me, will also be able to claim rights in the object, reducing my factual status to its temporary possessor or controller.
Okay, stop. What is the what did you say?
It's so amazing. Had we done this chapter one week before, maybe she was
talking about this. Here you have to be clever, you have to be intelligent,
But what happens is, as a result of this, a change of attitude comes number of absolutely.
But I was thinking of it the other way around.
Yeah.
So you have legal ownership on a flat. What if you place certain importance on owning your own home?
Yeah.
Right? Because you want security. So it gives you mental satisfaction and well-being. So that adds to my security versus taking away from it. If I have this flat and I know I'm going to go, but I'm going to leave it to my daughter, now that gives me more mental security because, you know, there's going to be something for them. The weightage on that unit is theirs, but it gives, it improves my quality of life because of my thinking, you know, or my comfort level going up, you know, my level of security and confidence, you know, changing.
So, exactly. So there are certain things which are factual. So that we are not trying to mess with, right? So this is why I said this kind of a value, you can't take it as, oh, I don't own anything, I've just come like that, and you are not living intelligently. So what Chirag is talking about is there are some factual advantage of legally owning a property. What are the factual advantages that you feel that, okay, you don't have to go from one place to the other, and then, you know, you have a place to live that you can pass on to your whoever. So this is wonderful. This you are not trying to mess with, okay? But for many of us, along with this comes this change of attitude. Change of attitude can result in actually what you are trying to feel is more secure, but actually you end up feeling more insecure because every morning you have to then check the prices of the property. Even if you are not planning to move, right, and you know that this is going to be passed on, what happens is, suppose the real estate market is down, it's a fact, and you can, but what happens is it makes you feel very uneasy. So that means the changing situations will bring about a huge turbulence in your thing. Even though factually you are not, suppose you are wanting to sell it, yes, you will be concerned about the price and all that. But even if you are not willing to sell it, right, the fall in property prices will create this whole big sense of, oh my God, what's happening to me? So these are the distortions that go along. So there is what we call one rational behavior, which is healthy and necessary. Then along with it, this is how our burdens in life increase. We seek things for our security, for our pleasure. And they do give us a little bit of that, but they also end up increasing our loads rather than reducing our loads. So suppose it was only meant for your security and it ends up giving you security, wonderful. But because of which, this sense of ownership, your change of attitude, if it begins to give you more anxiety, that means
it goes to zero and you're complete. Your security blanket is gone. Your attitude changes. And then your shit
starts. Not only that, like suppose you start getting obsessed about the title, or somebody can take it away from me. What am I going to do?
And
then
the family feud starts.
Yeah,
you
exactly.
know. So what you want to see is, you know, this sense of
equanimity regardless.
So that means there are certain things which are facts, but then our attitude towards it changes, and so many things become sour, right? So
you have a question. I've always wondered about this, because if this is there in our teaching,
yes,
why are Indians so, like, compared to Americans who give half their wealth away? I'm talking about billionaires and all.
Yeah.
But in India, that's not the case. Despite this,
despite
this being
in
the teachings,
yeah,
it's, you know, I've never understood why we're so, like,
actually, you know, it's interesting. I don't know what people tell me, you know, when foreigners come to India, they tell me, I ask them, how do you like the country? They said, you know, they are most touched by generosity of a common man.
But the common man?
Common man. So that means
it's
in
there.
It's in there.
Yeah.
They said
they
have very little, but they are so happy when they see somebody, and they are so willing to share.
It's so true.
And he says that we have never seen in Europe, that you know, that just somebody comes and you are willing to, even if you have like 5 rupees in your home, you are willing to give 3 to them without thinking about what am I going to eat. That is something about India that touches them the most.
Yeah.
Now, as you
become.
See, this is what I'm saying. You can have a culture and you can have a whole big philosophy, but that doesn't prevent people from not having a distorted attitude. So that sometimes people, the universe gives you a lot, and instead of being grateful and using it responsibly, it, you know, you become arrogant, you begin to look down on others. So those distortions are so common. So this is why this book, Value of Values. So either you can be gracious, and we are not talking about not actually, you know, wanting any, you know, any blessing that is endowed on us, that we have to use. At the same time, that when you, that is mixed with sense of ownership, what happens? Everything begins to change for you. It actually begins to be a burden and a source of anxiety, source of stress, source of this thing which you actually don't want. So that means if you can live in this world with having healthy relationships with things, that is the best. But sometimes you begin to think that you own it. That itself, that sense of ownership leads to all these insecurities. So therefore, even if, for example, I mean, now I don't want to give an example, but what sometimes when you really want something and things are going well, still you can't sleep at night. Why?
What do you think about it?
Yeah. So that means it's occupying you. You're buying it for your security, but what is happening is you're spending sleepless nights. Why? Because things are actually not that things are not going well. Things are going well. But there is this mind of yours which is not one all the time. The lack of trust. You see, ownership means you have this whole big thing of this trust in the universe, and within that, what? Doing what you have to do. This is the same mind. Otherwise, so the same thing. And this big wedding, right? So big wedding is actually a time of celebration. What is the purpose? And they spend some crores of rupees for celebration. So it's meant to have a good time. People spend sleepless nights if one thing will go wrong. Hey, one thing will go wrong, what's a big deal? Most of the people will not even notice. So that means the celebration becomes what? Source of stress. This is what the society we have created. Celebration is meant for celebration. It is not meant for stress. Every good thing becomes a source of our inability to enjoy things. That is, on one hand, we create this fantastic show, but if you look at your mindset while you're creating this fantastic show, it's not a celebrating mindset. And that is something which is actually a policy. So I keep reminding people, you know, because they are all close to me. So I keep reminding, hey, this is the time that you bless your daughter, you bless your son-in-law, whoever. This is not the time to say, oh, you know, did this flower man did this or not? That's, I mean, if the flower man did this and that, of course you think you, you know. But your mind cannot be so occupied with that that you, what, lose the main joy of these events in your life. Life can give you so much in abundance, so much grace, but your mind is never available. You create monsters out of everything. So this is this value. Really, it is a beautiful value. It seems he's saying simple things, but it's actually saying very, very big things. And where do they come from? They come from this everything you want to be under your control. That control is a big issue. You want everything to go exactly as you have planned. And you, endless, it's endless. So there is some amount of, you know, yes, you have to plan things well. That is your, you know, and then you have to do things well, sure. But then obsessive things that can create havoc. So this is what we are talking about. When you have this, you know, and it, lack of this ownership, sense of ownership, the more and more factual you become, you do what needs to be done. And as a result of that, what the loads that we carry, they reduce. because when we overdo things, then what happens? We lose perspective. And in that loss of perspective is our loads. Same thing, right? I mean, this is very school admission for kids. Yes, you have to be good, you have to, you know, prepare well and all of that. But obsessive means that you'll go crazy. So, you know, essays are meant for you to show what you think and who you are so that they can see who you are. Then you run to this counselor and that counselor, it has got nothing to do with you. And then, oh, where is he going and how is he, how much he is paying, and oh, now the counselors have become so expensive. Your whole mind is totally off track. What is that activity meant for? And where you to reflect on who you are and what you are doing is like lost track. So this is where this whole life goes like that. All chase and chase and chase, you can be the most successful person, the most all over the place and so stressed. So you are endowed with everything, but your capacity to enjoy and be grateful is never there because your mind is always chasing things and always insecure. So this is how we have to learn to see that I have been given this precious time on this earth. So many blessings. So what do I do? Be factual, be clever, and help myself and avoid all these words. Okay? So that is a beautiful thing. Okay. Next.